We just got the whole crew together and we're like, let's move to LA. And everybody's moved up to Hollywood. And then the same old thing. And then like Mariano was up here and Gino and Keenan Milton and everybody. We live right down the street from all those guys. And they were telling us, probably a little bit younger than those guys, not much, a couple years. And they were telling us like you guys gotta be careful, like this place is gonna like eat you guys up, you know? And we're like, nah. And then, like, 5 years later, everybody's all thrashed and, like, on drugs. And yeah, they were right. They were right. Yeah.
I think Brian Sumner, a skater we live with, he got me the camera, and I just wouldn't like. Well, I wouldn't take it if I'm in the picture, but I had it on me all the time and just started taking pictures, you know, of whatever was going on. I don't really know why or like why I would have even done it now, you know, looking back on it, like.
What's that?
I don't know. I wouldn't think like. That I would have been interested in carrying around a Polaroid camera and taking the pictures. Like at 20, you know? This Jim Greco, he used to just drink way too much at that table right there. That's all we would do is like, we would just sit at a table in an apartment complex.
And drink.
Yeah, and listen to like a little boombox. Yeah. The same thing, like all the time.
I'll tell a kid, you know, at this point in my life, like, no, stay away from that shit. Stay away from weed. Stay away from drinking. Stay away from drugs. It's like, it'll ruin your life and it'll mess up your skating. You won't be as motivated. So if anything, I could try to turn it around and try to be like a better influence, you know? Because now I know, like, being sober for 9 years or whatever, that like. It's just fun for a little while, but it takes away like what's really important in life for some people. I don't know anything else. You know, I don't know what it would have been like without it. All I know is with it, you know, so like everything I've ever done, traveling, everywhere I've ever been, pretty much skating has taken me there. So I can't say, like, yeah, this is what it was like, then this is what it was like. This is the only way it is the way with me, with my skateboard, going everywhere around skating with my friends, and that's all I know, you know? I don't know what the other way would have been, or what it's like, or what it's like to, like, work at a grocery store or like do high school dances and stuff like that. You know, I don't know like that life. I just know like skateboarding. Best thing I ever could have, that ever could have happened to me. You know what I mean? Like, I see the other options for like someone who comes from a small town like myself and like kids I grew up with. The options are slim, you know, if you decide like, I'm gonna stay in this small town and I'm gonna work or do whatever, you know? It's like, I'm sure you can find happiness with, like, other things, like family and kids and just that stuff like that, you know? But, like, I don't know. I got a really good deal, you know? Everything turned out really cool. That is important to me, that the companies are owned by skaters, because, like I said before, is like, if a corporate guy that's not a skater decides this isn't making him any money anymore, they can stop it at any time. But a skateboarder with his own friends involved will go sell the car and the house and be like, you know what, I'm gonna make this work because this is my people, you know? Somebody that's just a businessman that's involved with owning a company, they're not gonna feel the same. It's not their people, they don't care, you know? It's like, and maybe they do, I don't know, but that's my thinking. Like, I don't care about sports companies at all. So I don't think they're gonna care about what we're doing. But not right now. They're making a lot of money, so they're gonna care, you know? Taking away the moments that make up a dull day. Fritter and waste the hours in an offhand way. Picking around on a piece of ground in your hometown. Waiting for someone or something to show.
Put it into words. I just want people to feel how I felt when I watched like all right, they put out 15 minutes of John Cardiel footage on the computer the other day, and it was all reggae music. He listens to reggae music. I watched it, like all his whole entire career, and I was like just speechless, like. I thought I was gonna cry when I watched the whole thing. It was just like, this guy is so fucking badass. He's the, like, I was like, whatever I felt right then, I want people to remember me like that.
The Squeak Majesty, eastvillagevideo.com, Deadly Dragon Sounds, and we have a special guest, John Cardiel, in the studio. How's it going, John?
It's going good. I'm super excited to be here.
I'm super excited to have you. That's great. You totally killed it when you played with us at Downtown Town Green Game. Watch your hands
move. I can watch this all day long. Look at this. Jeez.
It's yours, and nobody else's. That is gonna be not selfish. In your doings, pass it on. Pass it on. Help your brothers in their needs. Pass it on.
Shut you down real quick with his skating. It's just like, that's a boss move right there. You know what I mean?